Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Android Studio on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily use this Android Studio for creating Android projects and how to run that right on your Android phone itself. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in the middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install the latest version of Android Studio, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and search over here, Android Studio download, hit enter. So that will show you this developer.android.com. So just simply go to their official site and you'll be landed over to the official site of Android Studio. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. So once when you are here, you will get this download button. So just simply click on this download button. So that will show you these terms and conditions. You must read this, accept it, and click on download Android Studio Meerkat. So Meerkat is the latest version at the time of making of this video. So when you'll be watching this video, you might see a different version, but no need to worry, the steps that I am going to mention on this video will be pretty much same. So whichever version you get, just download that, alright, and then follow that same process what I am doing on this video. So you can see that our Android Studio is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser and I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that latest version of Android Studio is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 1.22 GB. Just simply double click on this installer to install it locally on our system. So it's verifying installer, and there you go. So relax for administrative privileges, click on yes. So welcome to Android Studio setup. So let's minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next. So here if you see, it has given a couple of options. So that is Android Studio, and then it has also checked this Android virtual device. So currently if you see, the space required is 3.9 GB, right? So if you want to install a virtual device, that you can do, but you need to have this much amount of free space, and it will also going to download this virtual device and emulator, you know, from internet. So you need to have more bandwidth as well. What I'm going to recommend you is to uncheck that. So immediately we'll see that it is, you know, decreased by 1 gigabyte, right? So now it is 2.9 GB only. So why I'm telling not to install virtual devices, I guess everyone is using at least one Android phone, right? So you can use that Android phone itself for running the application that we are going to build, right? So there is no need to install a virtual device and make your system slow. So that's what I feel, and I also recommend to all of my students. So that's why I'm going to uncheck that. No need to occupy a lot of space on our drive, which will anyway going to make our system slow. So I'll recommend to uncheck that and click on next. So this is where our Android Studio is going to be installed, totally fine, click on next. So it's going to create an Android Studio folder, totally fine, click on install. So immediately we'll see that our installation is rightly begun. So let's wait for a couple of minutes over here. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Android installation is rightly completed. So just simply click on next over here. So start Android Studio is rightly checked, just simply click on finish. So that's going to start our latest version of Android Studio, that is Android Studio version Meerkat. Here it will tell whether you like to send some anonymous data to Google. You can always send that. For now I'll just simply click on don't send, and there you go. So welcome to Android Studio, just simply click on next over here. Now it is giving you a couple of options. One is standard installation and custom installation. I'll always recommend you to proceed with custom installation. So select that and click on next. Here again, if you see, it has, you know, checked this couple of options. So one of them is Android emulator and another is Android virtual device. So as I told you at the very beginning of the video, we don't want to install a virtual device. We already using Android phone, so you're going to use that for running your Android app. All of that I'm going to show you on this video itself. All right, you don't need to worry. So you know, you can see that total size is 2.26 gigabyte. As soon as I uncheck that, you can see it reduced, right? Reduced to only 631 MB. I'm going to uncheck this as well. So now only thing that I want to install is this Android SDK, Android SDK platform, and all the Android versions starting from Android 15.0. All right. So I'm going to select only this and click on next. So totally fine. Click on next. So this is license agreement. You must read this, accept it, and click on finish. So that's going to immediately start downloading some of the components. You can see, you can always click on the show details and you can see how it is doing. So it's going to download a lot of files from internet and going to install it. So you need to have active internet connection also. So now let's wait for some time over here. And by the time it gets installed, I'll also request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Script along with Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. Along with, you can also watch our WordPress videos. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are 1 hour 30 minute video. So you can watch all these videos on our channel for completely free. So basically you can watch this entire playlist. Alright, so all these links I am going to provide on our channel description. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our installation is rightly completed. So you can see our Android SDK is updated. So everything is fine. So just simply click on finish over here and that will open Android Studio. So let's first maximize it. So welcome to Android Studio. So let's create a simple Android project. So just simply click on this new project that will open this new project window. Here let's select one empty activity. So I'm going to select this and I'm going to click on next. So here we need to provide our project name. So let's give the project name as Hello Geeky Script, and it's going to automatically set our package name. So our package name will be com.example.hello-geeky-script. You can also change this, let's say GS, short form of our channel name Geeky Script. So com.gs dot then name of our project, which is Hello Geeky Script. You can give your own project name. All right. So next is, this is where our project is going to be saved. So you can see on our users, it's going to create a folder called Android Studio Projects, and within that it's going to create our folder of Hello Geeky Script. And minimum SDK version, that is very important. You can see it is Android version 7. So API version is 24. So you can always click on this help me choose. So that will open all this data that is graphically shown over here. So starting from Android version KitKat, it is showing that number of users they are currently using these Android versions. So maximum users are there in KitKat Lollipop version, so about 99.7. And as you go down, you can see that API level 34, it is about only 13% of the users are using, right? So you know what I am going to recommend you is to select somewhere, you know, in middle in the sense like somewhere, you know, within 98 to 93, like in middle. This you should be selecting your own version. All right, I am going to select the default Nougat one, that will have about 97.4% of users using. So you should be selecting, you know, as per your requirement. If you are selecting some very latest version, so you'll get very limited amount of, you know, mobile devices which will support your project. Alright, you should select somewhere in over here. So here is the list. From here you can choose all these versions. I'm going to proceed with this Nougat. And next we have this build configuration language. So we have Kotlin and Groovy. So I'm going to proceed with Kotlin and I'm going to click on finish. So that's going to immediately start creating our project. You can see it is rightly started creating. So in middle it's going to ask to provide permission to firewall because it is blocking some of the features. No need to worry, just click on allow access. You can click on allow access. so that it can connect with internet and can, you know, download all these packages. So you can see it is currently downloading and importing some of the libraries from internet. So it's going to take some time to, you know, properly create our project. So let's wait for some more time over here. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that finally it is done. So you can maximize this. So you can always read about this, what's new in Meerkat. And, you know, I'll just minimize this for the time being. And this is the interface of our Android Studio. And one thing I want to mention over here is that here, if you see the system information, I am using i5 processor. All right. So in my previous videos, I have showed you about Android Studio on i3 processor. This time I'm using an i5 8th gen processor, and I have only 8 GB of RAM. All right. So these are all virtual memory and all, you can always see, but I have just 8, you know, GB of RAM and i5 processor. All right. So, and I can clearly see that it is working much better on i5. All right. So what I observed, I just wanted to mention about that. So our app is also rightly over here. So if you expand this app, you will get manifest and Kotlin plus Java. So expand this and you will get this package com.example.hellogeekyscript that we have created. So if you expand this again, you will get this mainactivity.kt. So that exact same file is opened over here. So here is our code. So here, if you see, first we have a hello, and then we are getting a parameter called name, and it is printing this Android. So hello Android is what it's going to print on our app. So if you change this Android to something like Geeky Script and just save this file, and when you're going to run this, it's going to show you this hello Geeky Script output right on our Android app. So first you need to do some configurations on your Android phone. So just go to settings on your Android phone and go to my phone, then version info, and then you will get build number. Keep on clicking this build number. You can see now three step away, two step away from being a developer, and finally it will ask you to provide your pattern. So I'll provide my pattern, and you can see the message clearly shown, you are now a developer. So in this way, you need to enable your developer mode first on your phone. So by clicking this build number 5 or 6 times, it's going to show you that option, and that's how you enable your developer option on your phone. So it is very important to enable developer option on your phone. And once you've done that, just go to system and you will get this developer options enabled over here. So you have to click on that, and that will open this use developer options. So you can see it is right enabled, so totally fine. Now you need to scroll down, and you need to enable this USB debugging. So enable that, click on OK. So once you do that, it's going to use your phone as a developer options, and also it's going to enable USB debugging. So you are now good to install any Android app from your Android Studio. So only thing that you need to do now is you need to, you know, connect your phone with a USB device with your laptop. So just do that. I'm currently doing that. Once you connect your USB with your laptop, immediately it will show you this pop-up. So just, you know, check this option and click on allow. And you need to also enable your file transfer. So just, you know, enable this file transfer. So you need to enable your file transfer, and then you need to allow USB debugging. Immediately it will show you the setup over here, and on your Android Studio it's going to show you your phone over here. You can see it is directly showing over here, right? Infinix, the phone that I'm currently using. You can also use Wi-Fi, so you need to be connected on same Wi-Fi network, and you can, you know, through Wi-Fi you can send the build version of this app right on your phone. So I'm going to discuss about that on my next videos. For now, let's, you know, start with USB. So it is rightly done. So just simply click on this run button, and immediately we'll see it's rightly started building our project. So once when it gets successfully builded, it's going to install our app right on your Android phone. So you can always click on the show all and you can see what it is doing. So it is first compiling and then going to build it, and you can see that our compiling is rightly done. It is rightly started building and running our project. So let's wait for some more time, and you can see that our Gradle build is rightly finished. And right on your phone you can see the output, hello Geeky Script. So whatever you have written over here, so first hello it is coming and then Geeky Script, so that exact same thing is coming over here. So you can add some more text over here, so you can just add something like I love pizzas, and then just simply click on this run app and you'll see it going to again start building our project. This time it will be a little quicker and you can get that output again also coming on our phone, right? So hello Geeky Script, I love pizzas. Alright, so in this way you can easily install latest version of Android Studio and you can use your Android phone itself for running Android apps right on your phone itself. So in my next videos I'm going to talk about more about all these different project layouts that we can use. So starting from this bottom navigation view activity, then this navigation drawer views, all that including game activity on my next videos. So don't forget to subscribe your channel and also press that bell button to get notified. And if you have faced any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And also don't forget to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax along with Geeky Script. And also if you're interested, you can always watch our WordPress videos on our channel for completely free. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. Alright, so that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this.